Despite appearing primitive, artillery remains vital on the battlefield, serving both defensive and offensive purposes. An artillery barrage effectively suppresses enemy activity and can even have a psychological effect, demoralizing opponents. Moreover, it offers an economical and expedient alternative to air support, with modern artillery boasting significantly enhanced accuracy compared to its predecessors. Artillery systems excel in delivering highly precise indirect fire, effectively targeting enemy assets. Keeping these aspects in view, around 6 years ago, the U.S. Army unveiled the Long-Range Precision Fire, or LRPF, program with an aim to significantly increase the range of its artillery and land attack missile units. The latest budget documents indicate that the M1299 effort from the Extended Range Cannon Artillery, or ERCA, initiative, which is one of five major programs under LRPF, has not been successful. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the U.S. Army's ERCA M1299 Howitzer has failed. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. ERCA was seeking to nearly double the maximum range of the mainstay M109 Paladin self-propelled howitzer from the current 24 miles using rocket-assisted projectiles to over 40 miles, or about 65 kilometers. M1299, a 155mm self-propelled howitzer developed by BAE Systems, was meant to meet this goal. This range increase was to be achieved through the use of a new pressure-tolerant XM1113 rocket-assisted projectile, which entered service in 2016. Combined with a more potent propellant designated as XM654 Supercharge. Further, the 39 caliber XM907 gun tube has been replaced with a 58 caliber. Viewers may note that in field artillery, caliber refers to the tube of the gun barrel as opposed to the diameter of the bore. The 155mm diameter of the barrel is multiplied by 58 to determine the overall length of the barrel, which is equal to 29.49 feet. A longer barrel permits the expanding gases triggered by the shell powder to act upon the projectile for a greater period of time. In 2018, the XM907 gun tube achieved a 38.5-mile test shot firing from the carriage of an M777 towed howitzer. In 2020, the XM907 gun tube was able to fire at a range of 40.4 miles from the M1299. Further, the XM907 shot a target from 43 miles away using an M982 Excalibur GPS inertial guided smart shell, which fired from a regular gun has a maximum range of 25 miles. Things were looking good. A full battalion of 18 M1299 prototypes, plus two more for destructive testing, was delivered for operational testing by 2023. U.S. Army hoped that after the testing, they'd be in a position to place a production order. However, as 2023 passed, the M1299s stood as the sole program among the promised 24 by the U.S. Army to remain undelivered. The issue stemmed from barrel wear. The formidable gun firing potent shells was causing significant wear to its barrel. Continuous firing inevitably leads to the gradual deterioration of all artillery weapons. The wear is hastened during periods of high fire rates, causing the barrel to overheat rapidly and warp, as well as during long-range shots that utilize the maximum number of charges, resulting in maximal kinetic stress on the barrel. As barrels wear down, their accuracy decreases significantly. Moreover, barrels that are excessively used beyond safety tolerances pose a risk of exploding, endangering the crew and potentially causing the barrel to catastrophically deform. Such overuse is particularly prevalent in high-intensity conflicts such as the ongoing one in Ukraine. While there is no escaping the need to replace the barrels of artillery systems and tanks, the XM907 barrel was degrading too rapidly. Simply increasing the barrel thickness to address this problem would result in significant weight gain, potentially upsetting the delicate balance of the vehicle. Therefore, despite the M1299's capability to deliver remarkable long-distance shots, it would require frequent and costly barrel replacements, rendering it unavailable for operational service for extended periods. The U.S. Army had not identified a solution to the excessive wear issue by the time prototypes were delivered. A report from the Government Accountability Office cautioned that the program had exceeded the estimated budget by $78 million and was falling behind schedule. Consequently, the decision was made in 2024 to terminate what had initially appeared to be a promising, rapid, and cost-effective project. Officials estimate that Russia is currently firing around 10,000 shells a day, while 2,000 a day are being lobbed from the Ukrainian side. As evident from the Ukraine-Russia conflict, artillery will continue to play a significant role in any modern battle. M1299 would have been suitable for hitting high-value targets deep behind enemy lines, such as air defense systems, command posts, bridges, and of course, enemy artillery. The U.S. Army intended to further extend the range of the M1299 to 70 to 80 miles by utilizing even more advanced 155mm Extended Range Artillery Projectile, or ERAP, shells. In 2023, Boeing's Ramjet 155 shell, fired by an M1299, apparently set a record for the longest indirect fire test of a Ramjet-powered artillery projectile, though the range wasn't disclosed. So the issue with the XM907 gun has resulted in a bottleneck. But barrel wear can't be ignored. The service opted to return to the initial planning stage and is now soliciting proposals for alternative solutions. It'll be interesting to see how things go from here.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.